नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। वेलकम ऑल द डिवोटीज डिसाइपल्स समाजीस सत्संगीस श्रीमहंस महंस तानेदार कोटारी विजिटर्स व्यूवर्स एवरीवन सिटिंग विद अस थ्रू नित्यानंद टीवी साधना टीवी लोटस न्यूज चैनल एंड आरआर टीवी एंड टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग हैविंग नयनदीक्षा सिटीज सिटिंग विद अस इन टू वे वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसिंग हैविंग नयनदीक्षा कुलालंपूर आदीनम ओक्लाहोमा आदीनम तिरुवान्मियूर आदीनम लॉस एंजेलिस आदीनम हैदराबाद आदीनम सेंट लुईस आदीनम सैन होसे आदीनम मॉन्ट्रियल कनाडा टोरंटो कनाडा आदीनम चाइना मेलबर्न आदीनम रेडमॉन वाशिंगटन सरे कनाडा सियाटल आदीनम नित्यानंदेश्वर हिंदू टेंपल लॉस एंजेलिस ओहायो आदीनम एंड ह्यूस्टन Santa Fe, New Mexico, Amersfoort, Netherlands, Enriching Temple, Bidadi, Nityananda Nagaram, Hyderabad, Sun Prairie, Wisconsin, Warrington, UK, Singapore, Adinam, Monterey, Mexico, Nityananda Nagaram, Bidadi, Vancouver, Kuala Lumpur, Adinam, As Melbourne, Adinam, Toronto, Adinam, San Jose, Adinam, and Seattle, Adinam. Mukta Seattle, some more cities are joining. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. The intensity of Shivoham can be heard in the cough sound. The amount and kind of a cleansing going on. Sound that actually first cleanses your vocal cord. That is why the sound which comes from outside also cleanses your vocal cord. The whole Shivoham process in inner awakening in Varanasi is going so intensely. See, the intensity of the Shivoham process cannot be measured based on the amount of jumping and shaking. That I am not teaching eye jump, lung jump, please understand. It can only be measured based on the depth which you are going through, the kind of experience you are radiating, the way you are melting into Shiva, the aham merging into Shiva, aham merging into Shivoham, the way that your inner space is working in liberated thinking, it's only in that way the whole experience is flowering. Let me enter into Kathopanishad, the Shanti Mantra. Please recite the Shanti Mantra along with me. Om. Sahana Bhavatu. Sahana Bhunaktu. सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस् विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै शांति 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 शांति। लिसन, The whole concept of Indian education system, how it was, how it should be in future, how it was and how it should be in future, please understand, whenever I am glorifying the past, I am not indulging in it, I am visualizing it for the future. Listen, if the past makes you more and more powerless, you are indulging in it. If it makes you to decide to build your future again and again, it is vision. It is vision. Understand? All you need to do in your life, all you need to do to make what you want as reality, looking at the right past that gives you courage, hope to relive it, to recreate it, the real future. Here the word past I use should be understood not from the context of your past, but from the context of collective past. Understand, whenever I am describing about Vedic tradition, I am describing the glory of the collective past created by enlightened masters. I am not talking about your past. You have nothing to learn from your past other than nothing needs to be learned from your past. The only thing you need to learn from your past is nothing needs to be learned from your past. I am not talking about your past. When I am talking about the past, I am talking about the glorious rishis' past. The past created by the glorious civilization of rishis. How the Indian education system was and how it should be. The whole context is set in this one Shanti Mantra. Because the subject they are going to work, the subject which is going to be taught in this Upanishad is the essence of Indian education system. Please understand, Indian education system prepares you for death using that same principles prepares you for life. Please understand, first it prepares you for death, and then using the same principles prepares you for life. Because life is an option, death is not. Life is a possibility, but death is not. It is simple fact and truth and reality. Death is the only one thing which is fact, truth and reality. So the Hindu tradition educates you first, prepares you for death. From that context, prepares you for life. Yamadharma, the master who read the Akashic records about death in this Upanishad, and Nachiketa, the one of the greatest disciples ever born on the planet Earth. Please understand, the power and authenticity of the disciple is such, master serves him, gives him the boons and gives this knowledge. Not a single reference, Nachiketa served Yamadharma, no. But there is enough of reference in this Upanishad. Nachiketa was served by Yamadharma and his staff. Yama has staff, it is recorded in this Upanishads. Understand, the authenticity of the disciple is such, master decides to serve the disciple and teach and share the knowledge. When I try to introduce Yamadharma's teacher dimension, which is explained in this Upanishad, Kathopanishad, which is expressed in this Upanishad, Kathopanishad, I just can only use one word. Intensity, whether he tries to take the life in mass or he tries to teach. He's a no-nonsense man, I'm telling you. By taking away so many lives, doing his responsibility so well, he lost all sensitivity to the stupidity of human beings. He lost all sensitivity towards tears, emotions, ability to accept or unable to accept. He is not bothered about any of this. He lost all his concern about all this. I think that is one of the important requirements for a teacher, for a master. He should see to it the disciple becomes reality. Sometimes, out of pain, disciple will scream. He may not be able to accept. He may not be able to realize. There's a beautiful story in Shivapurana. When Vishnu took Varaha Avatara, means the pig body, to get the Vedas back. After the purpose was done, even after the purpose was done, he did not return to Vaikuntha, to his original state of Vishnu. He just got married to another one, female pig, and started giving birth, and he is happily enjoying the pig life, cozily having all his kids, running around with them, playing, enjoying, and the yuga is passing. This fellow is not returning to Vaikuntha. All the devatas are running to Kailasa. Oh Mahadeva, what is this? Mahadeva says, just go and talk to him and remind him he is Vishnu, he is not pig. The devatas, they say that, no, no, we went and tried to talk to him, he just drives us out. Because he may be in the pig body, because he is a Vishnu, he has all powers, he is using all the powers and driving us out and asking us to keep away, and he just wants to be in that body, enjoying the cozy life. Without realizing he is Vishnu. Understand, there are so many Varahas here. Then finally Mahadeva sends Devi. Devi also could not do anything. She comes back and says, no, he is not recognizing me. He is not ready to even look into my eyes. Then Mahadeva decides, no, it is now too serious. He goes and goes and picks up the Varaha Avatara by neck and just kills him, straight. No talking, nothing. He just tears the body. The moment that consciousness came out, he realized, yeah, I am a Vishnu. I am Parandama, Vishnu. I have to go back to Vaikuntha. And he stood in front of Mahadeva and saying, really sorry. that you have to come down from Kailasa all the way to free me. Please understand, when you are steering, it seems that pig was crying, calling out every name. But if Mahadeva cares for the pain of the pig, will the Vishnu happen? At some time, you can't. A master has to make the disciple stand. Here the whole subject is death. Death himself is talking about himself. He has already become insensitive to stupidity of human beings. He just stands tall to the truth of human beings, the possibility and reality of human beings, because he has already achieved insensitivity to stupidity of human beings because of his intensity. Now he is so straight. Please understand, no other book. Now I am not disrespecting Mahadeva. Even Mahadeva's description about death in Shivagamas and Tantras cannot be compared to Yamadharma's description of death in this Upanishad. No comparison. Because that needs a kind of a personality. See, a teacher needs a kind of a personality suited for the subject he is teaching. You can't expect the personality not being influenced by the subject he is constantly handling. That is why if you pick up all the maths teacher from all the college, they will look almost same. For a maths teacher, there is a special mold. For a science teacher, there is a special mold. For an English teacher, there is a special mold. For a Tamil teacher, there is a special mold. Almost in all schools, because the subject you are constantly thinking and indulging affects your personality. Here, death, whole day is indulging only in death. For Mahadeva, it's a part-time job. For Yamadharma, it's a full-time job. Whatever is said and done. See, Yamadharma may not be able to deliver many truths of different subjects, the scale of Mahadeva. But in death, no one is able to match Yamadharma. That one thing I should put it on record. I should make this available on record. Yamadharma is uncomparable when it comes to his subject. He is really the master. Master of his subject. Death. What a straight, uncompromising revelation on one of the most important reality of human beings, this Kathopanishad. Because of the authenticity of the disciple, Yamadharma does not need to compromise. Does not need to compromise. See, Devi is embodiment of grace. So whenever Mahadeva reveals some powerful reality which is painful for human beings or disciples to practice, Devi says, don't worry, Mahadeva, you should not be that strong. Through my grace, I will liberate them. It's okay. So the intensity of the teaching takes the back burner. It is like a when the Shivoham process started happening, the completion takes back burner. When the grace is flowing, your self-effort takes the back burner. But here, fortunately, Yamadharma's wife is not interfering. And Nachiketa is so authentic. He is all about truth. Just truth, truth, truth. He is all about truth. And the authenticity of the disciple, ability of the disciple to face the truth, gave courage to the master, Yamadharma. Yamadharma even wants Nachiketa, no, don't ask for that, ask for anything else. Nachiketa says, no. He even accuses Yamadharma of cheating him. No, I am not interested in anything else. Get me only that. I think that kind of a space which got created by the authenticity of the Nachiketa gave the courage to Yamadharma to reveal the truth as it is. Authenticity of Yamadharma, intensity of Yamadharma, and the sincerity of Nachiketa, the kind of the space they created for the delivery of the reality, delivery of enlightenment. I'm just trying to describe. Actually, whenever that kind of a space is created, the cosmos has to deliver enlightenment. And the best things has to happen. You can't even verbalize it. Only by creating that kind of a space I can show, demonstrate it is possible. So I invoke that space created by Nachiketa and Yamadharma here. Let the enlightenment happen. I bless you all. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Advaita, the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation